Hey guys, Ivan here, and this video we are going 20 years back in time. We are going to 1991 Mr. Olympia, when Dorian Yates placed second and Lee Haney won his last title. I know, the footage is not exactly that great, but guys, it was 20 years ago. Even today, most of the shows don't have exactly great footage, but we have some photos, we have some videos, we can come up with something. And my inspiration to make this video was not the 20 years anniversary. No, I did not wait for 2021 to make this video. I actually just saw this photo and I was mesmerized by it because it was very interesting. And that's how I came up with this topic. So, Dorian Yates is known for one body part, actually two body parts. One of them is calves, but more importantly, more important muscle was back. His back was one of the best backs ever. It's arguably the best back of all time. At least if we're talking about the Mr. Olympia winners, so it's between him, Ronnie, and Phil. But right here, Lee Haney is absolutely annihilating Dorian in the back department. So how is this even possible? Well, this was 1991. Dorian won his first Mr. Olympia in 1992. And in 1993, he made that crazy jump where he came much bigger. And then later, he got even bigger. 1994, 1995, 1996... he was bigger and bigger, but this was before he won the Mr. Olympia, and this time, Lee Haney had a much better back. Lee Haney retired very young, I think he was 32, so that begs a question, how big, how good Lee Haney's back would have been if he competed until he was like 40? You know, Sean Roden won his first Mr. Olympia at 43, I believe, so today's bodybuilders are much older, they peak in their 40s, right? When they are about 35 to 40. So if Lee Haney kept training, kept trying to progress, how big his back would have been. But for now, let's watch some footage. So Dorian was 239 at this show, at the age of 29. And here is what he looked like. So he was spot on. He looked great. He was really conditioned. This was his first Mr. Olympia, and he already almost won it. But only in terms of placing. If you take a look at these two guys, you will see that the difference between first and second spot was rather large. One body part that Dorian had on Lee was legs.
Prepared psychologically to come here, even though it might be my first Mr. Olympia contest and people might think, well, he's going to be overawed by the occasion and intimidated. There's no way, you know, I'm prepared psychologically. I believe in myself and, you know, I'm coming here to show everybody what I've done.
Wow, the level of confidence on this guy. Dorian was always confident and that's because he was always putting the biggest amount of work in all the shows and it showed. His physique basically showed. And look at his lat spread. Wow, it was amazing even back then, his first Mr. Olympia. Most muscular, not really so much. He had great legs at this time. Back wasn't exactly that good. It wasn't exactly his best body part at the time. But the lat spread, that was his really good pose. And his conditioning and the muscularity. He was right there, breathing on Lee Haney's neck. But Lee was bigger. He had almost 10 pounds on Dorian. He was 5 years older. He was 1 inch taller. And look at the waist. He had a really small waist. His chest was definitely thicker than Dorian's. Probably thicker than Dorian's chest ever was, even at his biggest. This pose was amazing on Lee. I mean, with small waist, big arms, big chest, and back. Look at the back. You can see it here from the side. He had a really good back. Later on, Dorian surpassed Lee Haney's back, but not by far. I mean, this back was really good. The legs could have used more work. Because Lee Haney, he was a transition between the golden era and then the mass monster era. He was right there in between. I mean, he was big, but he didn't have as big legs as guys had later. Though his back was really massive and the conditioning was like in between, right? I mean, that was a transition. For many people, that's basically the ideal physique. Massive enough, proportionate enough, but me personally, I would prefer something more of a mass monster. I like Dorian Yates' 1993 version probably as my favorite physique. And here, let's take a look at Lee Haney's back one more time. It was massive, man, it was massive. You can see that the legs could have used more work. And the posing was different. They were holding their legs a little bit more narrow, they had a narrow stance. That kind of posing creates a good V-taper, but what judges wanted to see was an X-taper. They were striving towards that, like Ronnie used to do. So again, Lee Haney's back was phenomenal at this point. I mean, people underestimate his back. It was a really, really good back. Dorian's back was fine. It wasn't bad. Lee Haney killed Dorian in chest department. In back department, he didn't exactly kill him, but his back was better. I mean, Dorian being known as the best back of all time in many people's books, in 1999 outclassed by Lee Haney, was something I found very interesting and I want to share it with you. Alright, how about we take a look at some comparison? It is a poor quality video, but it is what it is. So here you can see a very interesting top 6. Dorian, Lee Haney, Vince Taylor, Sonny Schmidt, Sean Ray and Lilo Brada. We will focus though on these top 2 guys, Dorian and Lee. And here are some quarter turns, so you can get the idea of the size difference between these two guys. And you can see that the size difference wasn't exactly big. I mean, it was pretty close as far as the size. Lee Haney had a little bit more density toward the back, toward the chest, not toward the legs, I wouldn't say so. And as far as conditioning, maybe Lee was even a little bit sharper, but Dorian always had that grainy kind of look, that grainy muscle. So it was very close as far as the conditioning, maybe even, let's say, the same level of conditioning. Basically, what determined the winner here, I think, was chest and back. And also the years of Lee Haney winning beforehand. So he won 7 Mr. Olympia titles before this show. So if you want to beat a champion, you need to knock the champion out. Here you can see the back thickness difference. Look at the lower lats. Look at it here. Lee Haney really had a really good back. And as far as the glutes, they had pretty much similar level of conditioning when it comes to glutes. Maybe Dorian was a little bit sharper, though he wasn't exactly flexing those glutes properly. I feel like it. Lats, back lats spread. Maybe Dorian had even better shape as far as the lower lats. He had really that crazy width. But then again, the mass on Lee was just overwhelming. Abs and thighs, you can't really see it properly. It's not the best angle. But after this show, Dorian was called Lee Haney with legs, or with better legs, because he did have great legs. You cannot really see it maybe in this comparison, but he did have great legs. And here you can see that the thickness and the level of muscularity was similar on both of these guys, but the chest mass. Lee Haney had much, much more massive chest. Dorian's chest was a little bit flatter, and it was always his weak point, even in his later days. You can see it clearly here in this high quality photo comparison. We're gonna see a couple of other shots in these high quality photos because the video footage was pretty bad. Right here, it's a night and day difference. It's man versus boys, basically. The size of the chest, not even comparable. Not even funny. I mean, Lee's chest is like 3 times bigger. Now, in this shot right here, you can see that, for example, glutes of Dorian were sharper, his legs were bigger. It probably has to do with his posing as well. But as far as the backs, it's not a big difference. Even though Lee Haney has the angle, Dorian looks probably better. But I think he's just flexed. He's fully flexed and Lee Haney is still in a transition. He still didn't flex completely. But you can still see that Lee's back is more massive. You can still see it. Even though it doesn't show as much detail as Dorian's, I think it's just not fully flexed. Here you can see that Dorian had that crazy potential to make that back absolutely ridiculous, as he did, but Lee's back was more massive, you can see it here clearly. The legs though, Dorian had the legs, he had better legs, calves and quads and hamstrings and glutes as well. But it just wasn't enough to knock out the great Lee Haney. Here you can see the difference in the biceps and the arms. Again, another thing that Lee had that Dorian didn't. Dorian is always known for having pretty weak arms and the waist. Also, Lee had better waist. So Dorian, I mean, when he was at his prime, he was beating everybody because he was just bigger and more conditioned than everybody else. But if you pick him apart, he didn't have that many dominant muscles. And if somebody was as big and as lean, anybody would beat him if they had more dominant body parts like Lee Haney did. It's just that later on, guys like Flex, Kevin, Sean Ray, Nasser or somebody, they all had better body parts than Dorian, but they were never really able to be that big or that conditioned. Another great shot of Dorian, where you can see his potential for greatness. He's out-angling Lee Haney here, and that's why he probably looks better, but you can still see the thickness in the chest and the arms. I mean, the waist size as well. Lee Haney had him for sure, but the potential, the promise was there. Lee Haney noticed that, and that's why probably he never competed again. He retired after this year, after his 8th Mr. Olympia win. Here you can see that the size of the legs is on Dorian's side. It's more proportionate as well. And the size of the chest and the arms, of course, it's Lee Haney, but I prefer the way Dorian is hitting it with his shoulder low. And Lee Haney is lifting his shoulder up a little bit. He's flexing his chest as well. Though Dorian had really poor shoulders as well. but when he hits this pose, it just flows pretty well. I like it. And here, of course, I would go with Lee, but Dorian is holding his own. And once again, for the end, the photo that really made me make this video as a back double bicep shot. So in a back double bicep, it's night and day. It's night and day. Back lat spread in the transition, it's close, but when they do a back double bicep, you can just see the difference in the lats. Look at this mass, this humongous amount of mass that Lee Haney carries in the latissimus muscles. I mean, it's just freaky. Dorian showed nice insertions, but the mass was lacking. He made it in later years, but here it was not close, not even close to Lee Haney's mass. And this is an interesting moment from this year's Mr. Olympia, and it is basically Lee Haney punching Dorian in the head, in the face. So people warned Dorian that Lee Haney is very aggressive on the stage when there is a pose down, and this happened. First, Dorian tried to challenge Lee Haney, so Lee Haney did a crucifix pose, and then Dorian does a lat spread. He's pushing Lee Haney's arm, so he can't really do a proper crucifix pose, and then Lee Haney fights back. He's basically pushing Dorian's face with his fist when he's doing a crucifix pose. So this was also a great rivalry. These guys became great friends later on, but they were a little bit physical, a little bit confrontational at this point. Of course, as you know, Lee Haney won that Mr. Olympia, Dorian was second, and there are people who think maybe Dorian deserved it more. What do you think? Do you think that was the case? From what I can see right here, I can see that Lee Haney had worse legs, but conditioning was pretty much the same, though he had better chest, better arms, smaller waist. And Dorian, who was really known for having the best back of all time, did not have a better back than Lee Haney on that day, on that night, in that year. So 20 years after this Mr. Olympia, we are making this video. I think it was a fun topic. If you guys enjoyed this video, please like it and subscribe for more videos like this. And make sure to let me know what are your thoughts down below in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and all the best, guys. Bye-bye.